Good afternoon. All right, so I had the meeting with the players this morning to review the game, talk to them about the game, showed them a bunch of different clips of the game, and really segmented into a couple of different things. Really was the opportunities that we had in the game was the first thing. And when I mean that, I mean the interceptions, right, the caused fumbles that we had that we didn't get, sacks that we got to do a better job tackling, getting guys behind the line of scrimmage, opportunities that we had on offense to take advantage of coverages that were given or run fronts that we had. And I showed them all those. And that was for a reason, you know, because everybody's held accountable to make those opportunities count. And we got to do a better job as a group seizing those opportunities, because those could sway the game for sure. No question about that, you know. And then I showed them things that we could do well, you know, things that we did well, you know, and the chunk plays on offense, you know, with those two drives that we had, that was outstanding, both leading to touchdowns. I showed them those. That was good. And then really defensively, you know, the stops that we had at the end of the game, that make them punt, force those punts in the second half when they had a 10-point lead to get the ball back for our offense to go ahead and score, to make it a one-score game, to go ahead and win it. And then also stop them at the end to give us the thing for 2 minute when it was 2:25 to go to be able to score to take the lead. We all broke up. I went with the defense and showed those guys the tape from there. Luke went with the offense. HT went before, and we're just making the corrections. A couple guys that were good, you know, that stood out. You know, I really want to commend the guys that came in for injury. You know, we got those Hicks came in, you know, Quindell came in, Strowman came in. Those guys all came in for injury, and I thought they operated solid in that situation. You know, we had a couple guys with heat-related deals, but overall, I thought our team handled it pretty good for the most part. To start the game, you know, you look at the game the way it started. You know, love that first drive. With the offense, it was excellent. You know, and then on defense, you know, we had a long drive, but we came out of that, you know, with the field goal. So it's that was good. And then the block kick. You know, we talked about that after the game. You know, really good job by HT setting that up. I thought Dylan did a really good job on that one. You know, obviously Rasheen got the block on that, and we returned it to the 50. And that's again one of the opportunities that I'm talking about. You get the ball at the 50 there. We got to do a good job of capitalizing on that, you know, in terms of a field goal or a touchdown, you know, in that moment there. So solid 2 minute at the end of, you know, with the defense. Obviously, you want to stop there shorter than that, but you held them to a field goal. I thought the guys did a good job operating, you know, in the red zone, you know, as they went to finish the half right there. You know, and then coming out of halftime, you know, we just got to do a better job. You know, we got to create that momentum and create those opportunities coming out of second half. You know, get some first downs, get the ball to the plus side of the field. We had to do a better job there. And then defensively, I thought, you know, the second half was solid. You know, we forced some punts. We did some good things. Wish we had that 3rd and 14 back, you know, in the high red zone. You know, certainly got to execute better in that moment to force them to kick a field goal there. Like I said, overall, we're disappointed, you know, that we lost. But I do see opportunity there for us to improve. I do see opportunity in the game for us to be able to sway that game one way or the other, all the way up to the very end. And that's where I see it. And the guys are excited about moving forward to Kansas City. Their eyes are forward. They're working hard. And all we got is the practice field. That's all we have, you know, to bring this group together. Offense, defense, kicking. We just need to have to do a good job with that because, you know, that's all we have is the practice field. We got Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, then we got to go to Saturday, then we play the game. So, obviously playing a good opponent this week, defending champs, and we're excited about it. So, with that, I'll open up to questions.
Matt, with the pick six, when you go back and review all of it, if you've given a do-over, how would you readjust, whether it's the play call decision, pre-snap diagnosis of things, or the post-snap?
Yeah, the pre-snap diagnosis is there, right? That's a great look for that particular play. You know, they're in shell defense. The linebackers are all back. There's no one really taking the back in that situation. He's a zone cover guy. You know, so the pre-snap in terms of what Justin was doing was A1. So there's nothing wrong there. So
would you want to talk through a different play call, and then post-snap, what would you want to have?
Yeah, I mean, you could run several plays down there. And, you know, that's one of the plays you could run down there, but you could run several plays there. But against that look and the 3x1 set they were in, with the coverage they were in, it was there.
Post-snap?
Yeah. Yep. They ran a TE game right there, and we got to do a good job. I think that JT was there. He could have maybe worked him upfield a little bit more, create a little more separation, and then dump the ball over the top. So that's where it was.
Sorry. How did Justin Fields grade out overall after you watched the today?
Yeah, I think that, you know, again, it was the consistency, right? I think he did a lot of good things, you know, in the game. You could see that. You could see his operations better with the offense. You can feel that. But again, we're just searching for consistency, you know, to be able to, you know, create those explosive plays, get the ball to number two, get the ball to 10. You know, we thought 10 played better, you know, blocked the perimeter better, did a nice job with those things, you know, and made a nice touchdown catch, you know, there. So we were excited about that. But yeah, just about consistency, about doing it right.
The consistency, like as you kind of indicated, really good with DJ Moore early in the game on that first drive, and then we don't really see much from DJ Moore until way later in the game on the touchdown drive to Claypool. So where does it go? What happens?
Yeah, I would just say that you got to look at the plays. You know, you have to look at the plays, but for sure, I know it's just about, you know, him getting the ball to the skill. You know, him getting the ball to the skill. You know, sometimes it might be the offensive line, sometimes it might be the receivers, it might be one or two things here and there, but we just got to get that consistency going.
Man, at the end of the first half, I think Justin hits Cole for a first down. You're at the Bucs 24, and you go no huddle. And it looked like he had some guys open, whether it was Roshan or Cole, kind of down the seam, and he ends up getting sacked. Was that a situation where it was a busted coverage or those weren't his main reads? How did you guys diagnose that play?
Yeah, so we were getting on the ball quick, you know, to keep them in their personnel. You know, so that's what we were doing there. And, you know, the play is really a four-out strong type of play. And, you know, it's designed to, you know, really, like, spread out the field. And we got to do a better job with our spacing there, you know, with our receiver spacing. You know, there was the spacing, you know, a little bit of an issue there with the spacing part of it. And we got to do a better job executing there.
Is that probably why he didn't throw it, because of the spacing, you think?
Well, that's the reason. There's a reason why there was a hesitation there.
Man, do you have an update on Eddie Jackson?
I can say what I said yesterday. I can say that it's still positive. I'm not sure where that's going to trend to for this coming week, but I can say that it's positive.
Man, from an outside perspective, even with modest expectations of what some people consider a rebuilding year, play of the first two games has been a disappointment. What issues have you had that you maybe didn't expect to have in these first two games that have kind of seemed to have kind of thrown you at least a little behind schedule?
I would just say that, you know, we're working hard, okay, number one, okay? The guys are preparing hard, okay? And we want to get the continuity, okay, with the players, okay, and the coaches, making sure the continuity's there with the offensive line, with the receivers, with the defense, the front seven, all those things, and that's what we're searching for, okay? And I did see improvement from the first week to the second week, which is a positive, okay? So we're moving forward to week three, okay, and we're going to keep stacking improvements up as we go. And like I said, if we seize those opportunities that we're at in the game, the outcome will swing the other way.
You had a lot of upgrades in the offseason that were, you know, it just seems like was too much expected too soon, or is it going to take longer than you thought for all these new guys to make an impact? Is that maybe the issue, or what, you know?
Yeah, I would just say that we're focusing on the here and now and getting better right here and right now. So that's all we can focus on. So making the corrections from the game, right, improving from week two to week three, and then moving on to Wednesday. Like I said, all we have is the practice, you know, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and the walkthrough on Saturday, and we want to improve during that time.
Matt, you guys have talked for a year about improving the rhythm and timing in the passing game. Yesterday it seemed to a lot of us that Justin had the same issues that we saw last year with pocket presence and going through his reads. Where do you feel like he's at in the rhythm and timing, and are you concerned that it's maybe not coming along as you guys would?
Yeah, I mean, you know, you certainly want to see the consistency there, okay? And you see flashes and you see improvement. You see that, right? And you saw the ball delivered down the field yesterday, which is all positive. Those are all positive things. And like I said, we just want to see consistency with that, you know? Take what the defense gives you, you know, if that long ball's there, the shot's there, the end cut's there, whatever the route might be. And if it's not there, then work down to your progression. So just about consistency, that's really what it is.
And is there anything that you can add today about Alan Williams, if he's coming back this week, if you're going to be calling defensive plays? Or?
Yeah, there's nothing to add. Nothing to add there at this time.
Okay.
Matt, yesterday a couple guys mentioned the mental lapses that you guys are having. Braxton talked about it. I think Chase talked about thinking it's a run play and it's a screen. Do you have a can you pinpoint the reason why you guys have had so many mental lapses early on?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't know if I would agree with a bunch of mental lapses yesterday. I think it was much improved. I think the guys were on the same page. I know there's a couple of plays in there what you're talking about, but yeah, that always needs to improve. All on the same page, alignment, assignment, key, and technique. Guys doing their thing, doing their job, and doing it fast. With good technique, with good violence. All those things that we talk about, and you're always searching for that.
It seemed like the pressure numbers increased from last week. Like you guys were around Baker a lot more than you were around Love the week before. What was the disconnect between seeing the production, whether it be sacks, hits, passes, takeaways? Why did the pressure not translate as much as it should have?
Yeah, I think it's just about technique. I mean, we were around them a bunch, so we had a bunch of opportunities, that I showed the D-line and the pressure players to get there, and Baker's strong. He's a strong guy. You got to tackle him a certain way. It's important that you do that. You got to get him around the waist, so we were just too high. We were too high on those moments, and we got to improve that going forward. So every quarterback's different how you get them on the ground. Some guys you got to tackle a little bit higher. Some guys you got to tackle a little bit lower. They give you a strike zone that you can tackle in. So that's what you always got to focus on. But every quarterback's different. We got to do a better job.
Two more. As kind of a bigger picture extension of that, when you talk about seizing opportunity and finishing plays and finishing drives and finishing games, and your experience coaching, what's the secret sauce to getting that finish that has been lacking?
I would just say it's about guys knowing what to do and knowing how to do it, and that's the coach and the player, okay, and playing fast. Because you can make up a lot of things with speed, right, and you can in aggression. You can do that. And you can cover each other up, I'm talking on defense. And then on offense, same thing. You know what to do, know how to do it, and do it fast. And to me, that's what good sound execution is, right? Like I said, we got a new football team this year, right? And it's week two, and we're improving from week one to week two, and we're going to improve week three. So that's all we got our eyes on right now.
Matt, did you address like any kind of morale issue? Do you feel like that's at 0-2 that needs to be addressed, or do you just count on whatever captain's leadership, whatever, to handle it?
No, there's nothing there. Nothing there. We are steadfast. We are straightforward, and we are all in this together. So it's coaches, players, and we are looking at a great Wednesday practice, and then looking into Kansas City. That's what we're looking at. Yep.
Thank you.
Thanks, Coach.